with specifically El Salvadorians, like the person that runs the pupuseria, and they're accepting Bitcoin, which is great. There's a place in El Zante that does vegan pupuserias. It's fantastic. How is the education, or how do you, or in terms of getting El Salvadorians to realize it's not just about accepting Bitcoin and how you can use it to pay for things, which that's pretty amazing that you yourself are like barely using fiat anymore, but how are you getting across and how is it being accepted? The concept of save a little, put a little Bitcoin aside and save it for the long run, because in the short run, it'll go, like a year ago, it was at 19, now it's at 52, but conveying to El Salvadorians, and this is a tough thing to convey to anybody,
yep.
But like, because I had some friends that bought it 3 years ago at 50, 60,000. And then when it dropped to 19, they're like, you know, and I'm like, just hang on to it, man. Yeah. Like, hang on to it, you know?
Yeah.
So how are you conveying that? And how is that being received of like, put some aside, because when Bitcoin gets to 100,000, 200, 500, a million, even if you have 3, 4, 5% of a Bitcoin, you're going to have a lot of money. How is that being taught, and how are people like, are they getting that? Are they realizing the value and power of that, the saving in the long run?
I think they do. It's again, it's a process. Not everybody gets it the first time. Mm-hmm. But especially, let's say someone in El Zante, if you go and ask a lady, oh, last year, let's say when the price went to 19, and they're like, oh no, we saw it at 20, and then we saw it at 60. And then like, so it depends of where you go here in El Salvador. So probably that people is getting a start. But now that we have, you know, every year that passes, you have more data and we can show them the cycles. Mm-hmm. It's like, this is what it is. You want to see what a Ponzi scheme is, and you can show them the graphic of another crypto, right? Like, that's a Ponzi scheme. So it's exactly how it goes. And we do teach that also, the cycles and what it's limited. And we explain, you know, what the halving is and the process. Like, you know, this is what it means. But because we explained what a scarce money can do, or it is, you know, how it changes. And then they realize, okay, if this is, you know, over time, it's going to increase the value. The price of Bitcoin is not going to go just because, right? It's also because of how it works. So that's how people understand, oh, okay, yeah, I can hold in it. But it's like you said, here in El Salvador, even, you know, if the minimum salary is $390, it's hard to save anyway.
Right.
So if you receive your salary and it's just $390, I mean, to save up $5 is already a challenge, especially if you're a mother, a dad, and yeah, have to pay it and everything. So it's mostly also the fact that the inflation, so you have $1, you want to spend it. You know that is why you're going to save money. It's so hard for you to save 5, 10, 20 a month to keep, you know, some cushion. And anyway, in 1 year, that's not going to worth the same. Like $100 that are very hard to save for you didn't. So that's what we try. It's like, you don't need to buy one Bitcoin. You just have $5 to save, fine. Just leave those $5. Check it out in 3 months, 5 months, even if it's just $1, you're going to see that it's more, it's not less. And that's how they start. Oh yeah, I see. Like, even if it's just cents. So of course they realize, okay, if I set 10, that means that I will have more. And it depends on the level and where they at and what the income is. But people understand that now, even with the cycles, you're saving for the future, right? You're not saving for tomorrow. You're not saving for next month. So they are understanding, I think, is just when we explained scarcity, when we explained cycles, that's what it gets in their minds, some more than others. There is younger people that probably have more incentives of saving for 1 year, and they have done it probably. And then 1 year is a year, right? So they see the cycles, and that they are basically orange pilling their parents. And it's just a chain of everybody trying to do their part.